We begin our celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Friends, as one family of God, as children of our Blessed Mother, we come together to celebrate the feast of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. When the Blessed Mother appeared to Catherine Labore, she said, "Come to the foot of the altar. Here graces will be given to those who ask with confidence and fervor." We gather together at the foot of this altar and present before Jesus all our petitions and needs, together with the prayers of our Blessed Mother Mary. Sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth His glory for the good will. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth His glory for the good will.
Let us pray. O God, who caused us to rejoice in your great goodness through the Immaculate Virgin Mary, so inexpressibly united with your Son, grant that as we are supported by her motherly protection, we may never be without your providential love and be always dedicated to the mystery of redemption with unbounded faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Revelation. A great sign appeared in the sky, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was with child and wailed aloud in pain as she labored to give birth. Then another sign appeared in the sky. It was a huge red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, and on its heads were 7 diadems. Its tail swept away a third of the stars in the sky and hurled them down to the earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman about to give birth, to devour her child when she gave birth. She gave birth to a son, a male child, destined to rule all the nations with an iron rod. Her child was caught up to God and his throne. The woman herself fled into the desert, where she had a place prepared by God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From age to age.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent His Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons. As proof that you are sons, God sent the Spirit of His Son into our hearts, crying out, "Abba, Father." So you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then also an heir through God. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Each year, his parents went to Jerusalem for the feast of Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up according to festival custom. After they had completed its days, as they were returning, the boy Jesus remained behind in Jerusalem, but his parents did not know it. Thinking that he was in the caravan, they journeyed for a day and looked for him among their relatives and acquaintances. But not finding him, they returned to Jerusalem to look for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were astounded at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished. His mother said to him, "Son, why have you done this to us? Your father and I have been looking for you with great anxiety." And he said to them, "Why were you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?" But they did not understand what he said to them. He went down with them and came to Nazareth and was obedient to them. And his mother kept all these things in her heart. And Jesus advanced in wisdom and age and favor before God and man. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Isang magandang araw po sa ating lahat. The recent pandemic coincided with the 190th anniversary of the apparitions of Our Lady to St. Catherine Labore, where she revealed the Miraculous Medal, or the Medal of the Immaculate Conception, which during the cholera epidemic in France at 1832 became more popularly known as the Miraculous Medal because of the physical healings and spiritual conversions. At ito nga pong nakalipas na pandemya, isa sa mga naging gawain ng apostolate, ng Miraculous Medal Apostolate, ay magpadala ng mga medalya milagrosa kasama ang kwento, paliwanag, at panalangin na kaugnay nito. Napansin ko po na marami yung tao ang biglang naghahanap at nagnanais makabili o makahingi ng Miraculous Medals. And from these persons who call our office looking for medals, from the most frequent and persistent ones, we were able to organize a network of devotees, individuals, karamihan po sa kanila mga doktor at nurse, medical practitioners and frontliners. We were able to organize them and individuals who'd like to spread the Miraculous Medal in a time of chaos, fear, and hopelessness. Noong nabuo po namin yung aming grupo, we made a group chat, and I remember I named our group chat Medals of Hope. And true to its name, our little apostolate of sending Miraculous Medals with its prayers became an instrument to give comfort and hope to those who are distressed and affected of the virus and pandemic. There were a lot of testimonies, miracle stories, and appreciation posts that was shared in our group chat. Most of them are healthcare workers, kasi karamihan ng pinapadalhan namin ng mga medalya ay mga nurse, pasyente, doktor, police, etc. I remember meeting one doctor who requested for medals for their hospital. She came to the Marian Center to pick up the medals, and we were able to talk to each other. Sabi niya sa akin, "Father, marami po akong kasamahan na naniniwala sa bisa at proteksyon ng Mahal na Birhen sa pamamagitan ng Medalya Milagrosa. Sa aming ospital po, regular ang swab test. At parate, halos karamihan sa amin na health workers ay nagpa-positive. Ngunit yung department po na hawak-hawak ko, bukod sa pag-encourage sa aking mga kasamahan na pag-ibayuhin ang pag-iingat at pangangalaga sa aming kalusugan, napagkasundoan po naming lahat na magsuot ng Medalya Milagrosa. Lahat na po ng paraan para lamang mapalakas yung aming loob ay ginawa na namin. Kaya lahat kami sa Pedia Ward nakasuot ng Miraculous Medal. At sa mga nakalipas na swab testing, ang aming grupo ang walang nagpa-positive sa COVID. Sabi niya sa akin, "Father, kahit po kami ay mga doktor at nurse, kami rin ay tinatabla ng takot at anxiety dala ng panganib na mahawaan dahil exposed kami sa mga pasyenteng may COVID. Kaya ako, bago mag-duty, habang isinusuot ko yung aking medalya milagrosa, inahawakan ko po ito malapit sa aking puso. Nagdarasal ako, sabi ko, Mama Mary, magsisilbi po ako sa aking bayan at kapwa. Kayo na po ang bahala sa akin at sa mga mahal ko sa buhay. Huwag ninyo pong pahintulutan na may mahawa sa amin sa sakit." Father, ika niya, ito po ang nagbigay ng pag-asa at lakas ng loob sa karamihan sa aming healthcare workers sa panahon ng pandemya. Ito po ang muling nagturo sa amin na magdasal at maging malapit sa Diyos. That simple medal, that tiny aluminum medal that we normally give to people, gave them a sense of assurance. It gave them a sense of hope na balang araw, malalagpasan din natin ang pandemya ang ating pinagdaanan. Mary, my dear friends, facilitates this encounter between us and Jesus. And even up to now, that most of us are suffering various kinds of problems, anxieties, stress, illness, Mary invites us to come ever more closer to the foot of the cross of Jesus. It is there that we will be given grace to bear and surpass all the hardships and danger we are going through. It is through the cross that redemption is given to us. The best way that we could honor Jesus and Mary is for us to continue to experience their intercession and help, is to serve as persons who are always ready to lend a helping hand to those in need. The question is, are we ready and committed to accept the duties and responsibilities of being followers of Jesus, of being Christians, of being children of Mary? Pilgrims of Hope is the theme for the Jubilee year next year. Pilgrims who rejoice in hope. Pilgrims who are willing to accompany the least and the lost. Pilgrims who are committed to serve Jesus and Mary in the various apostolates and works, even in our daily lives. May all of us devotees of Our Lady have a renewed fervor and enthusiasm in creatively and lovingly responding to the mission and call to spread the good news of Jesus and be the hope that comes only from Jesus. May we ourselves truly become pilgrims who together rejoice in hope, who together accompany each other, who together commit ourselves to the Church, to Jesus and Mary. Nawa, ang maging daluyan, tayo din ay maging daluyan, katulad ni Maria, ng pag-asa na nagmumula sa Diyos. Pag-asa na hindi bumibigo at nagpapaasa. Bagkos, tunay na nagbibigay pag-asa sa iba, lalong-lalo na sa Aba. As we continue the celebration of this Holy Eucharist on this Feast of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal, we ask the Lord for the grace to be instruments of the good news, to be instruments of hope in our world and times, especially to our sisters and brothers who are in need. Amen. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to you. Please stand and together we profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there we will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting.
Amen.
God our Father, source of all goodness, invites us to partake in his mission through Mary, our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. Let us ask him for our needs and the needs of all God's people as we pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the whole church, sign of unity and symbol of universal salvation, that we may continue to be rooted deeply in communion with Jesus, as Mary did during her earthly life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of the church and of governments, may they act against the injustices in our society, serve those who live in its fringes, and relieve suffering wherever it is found, especially in this time of pandemics and disasters. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christian communities, especially those who are exploited and oppressed, for the victims of war, terrorism, and tyranny, for prisoners, for the sick, the poor, and the hungry, for the homeless, and for those without work, that like Mary, may our faith in God strengthen us in our journey in fulfilling the will of the Father. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own conversion of heart, that through the intercession of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal, we may walk in the path of holy trust in the unfailing providence of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the dead, especially the members of the Vincentian family, our own families, friends, and benefactors, may receive the promise of eternal life in the company of Mary and all the saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and merciful God, you have given the world the Miraculous Medal as a symbol of your immense charity and love. Hear the prayers of us all who gather today to commemorate the Blessed Virgin, our Mother, and grant that we may have hearts of compassion for all who suffer. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Gloria, Patri, et Filii, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.
Please stand.
Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Lord, as we offer to you this joyful sacrifice of praise, we honor the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary. May we who rejoice in your goodness be able one day to offer you thanks forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you preserve the most blessed Virgin Mary from all stain of original sin, so that in her, endowed with the rich fullness of your grace, you might prepare a worthy mother for your Son, and signify the beginning of the Church, his beautiful bride, without spot or wrinkle. She, the most pure virgin, was to bring forth a Son, the innocent Lamb, who would wipe away our offenses. You placed her above all others to be for your people an advocate of grace and a model of holiness. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give light to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you, for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he said a blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which shall be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Vincent de Paul, St. Louis de Marillac, St. Catherine Labore, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Mom.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Friends, behold Jesus, Son of God and Son of Mary, conceived without sin. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
susundin mo ang tinig ng Panginoon at maingat na gagawin ang kanyang utos.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Lord our God, we have been refreshed by the sacraments of everlasting redemption as we rejoice in the celebration of the Immaculate Mother of your Son. May we advance more eagerly in our journey of faith and being participants here on earth at the table of your kingdom. May we merit to praise you together with her in heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
A blessed afternoon to everyone and a blessed feast of the Miraculous Medal to all of us. Palakpahan po natin ang ating Panginoon at ang ating mahal na ina. In the name of our beloved Rector, Monsignor Rolando de la Cruz, we would like to welcome all of you today for our celebration of the Feast of the Miraculous Medal. And we would like to extend our heartfelt gratitude to the following for making this feast day solemn and possible. With all our welcome, with all our gratitude goes to all of you. First, our beloved priests, my dear brother priests here present, we would like to acknowledge and thank our brother priest, Father Paul Wood, the chaplain of the Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary, SM Grand Central. Father, maraming salamat po. And as well, the director of the Miraculous Medal Apostolate, the one who really made it possible that every year, the image of the Miraculous Medal will make her visit to the Manila Cathedral, Father Roland Limhoco. Father Choi, maraming salamat po. And to the Miraculous Medal Apostolate, ang amin pong pasasalamat at muli ang amin pong mainit na pagtanggap po sa inyo at sa pagdadala lagi ng ating mahal na ina dito po sa Manila Cathedral. For our beloved Manila Cathedral community, the image will be staying with us up until tomorrow. You still have the time to visit and make your prayers in front of the Miraculous Medal. We would like to acknowledge as well our choir for this afternoon, the young chorister of Mary from the Malate Catholic School, with their teachers and instructors with them, and the school headed by their school director, Father Boy Biliran. Maraming salamat po. Sila po yung mga tinig natin ngayong hapon. Mga kids, maraming salamat po. Ayan. Okay. We would like to invite you tonight for our Wednesday Family Rosary, and as it is traditionally the feast of the Miraculous Medal, our host for tonight will be the National Shrine and Parish of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal in Muntinlupa City. Magtipon po tayo bilang isang pamilya upang patuloy na hilingin ang mga panalangin ng ating mahal na ina, lalo na po sa biyaya ng kapayapaan at kapanatagan sa mga oras na ito. Muli po, from our hearts, with all our greetings and gratitude mula po dito sa Manila Cathedral, maligayang kapistahan po ng Birheng Medalya Milagrosa.
Please stand.
We pay homage to our Blessed Mother as we sing to her the Salve Regina.
Salve.
Amen.
Let us pray the act of consecration to Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. O Virgin Mother of God, Mary Immaculate, we dedicate and consecrate ourselves to you under the title Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. May this medal be for each one of us a sure sign of her affection for us and a constant reminder of our duties towards you. Ever while wearing it, may we be blessed by your loving protection and preserve in the grace of your Son. O most powerful Virgin Mother of our Savior, keep us close to you every moment of our lives. Obtain for us, your children, the grace of a happy death, so that in union with you, we may enjoy the bliss of heaven forever. Amen. O Mary conceived without sin,
pray for us.
Napasalamatan naman na po ni Father Biel halos lahat. But from our end, nais po naming magpasalamat din sa The Manila Cathedral na binubuo ni Monsignor Rolando de la Cruz, Father Biel Bautista, sina Brother Romain, lahat ng staff, personnel, security, na parating mainit yung pagtanggap sa amin dito na naging taon-taunan na napagdalaw ng imahe ng Mahal na Birhen. Gayon din, nais ko pong i-recognize yung mga grupo, mga deboto na naririto from the Children of Mary Immaculate Vincentian Marian Youth, from the members of the Miraculous Medal Apostolate, the Association of the Miraculous Medal, friends and devotees of Our Lady of Lourdes, at sa lahat sa inyo, yung mga nagdiriwang ng birthday, kaya naririto, may God continue to bless each and every one of us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May God, who through the childbearing of the Blessed Virgin Mary willed in his great kindness to redeem the human race, be pleased to enrich you with his blessing.
Amen.
May you know always and everywhere the protection of her through whom you have been found worthy to receive the altar of life.
Amen.
May you, who have devoutly gathered on this day, carry away with you the gifts of spiritual joys and heavenly rewards.
Amen.
And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Go and announce the good news to all.
Thanks be to God.
Kami.
Itaas mo si Jesucristo aming mahal hanggang sa buhay na walang